Altars of Dun by Glenn Winkelmann, Jr. Above the gnarled trees of Dun hung the thin, waning moon, pouring its pale beams between horned branches, casting crawling shadows upon the uniform pits which lay below. Stygian crypts exhaled miasmal vapors of Earth's inner secrets, which collected around their summits of disheveled dirt and dry, aged bones. Archaic carvings of amorphous creatures and ragged, satyr-like deities rested amidst the crude courtyard, and upon the whole place there lingered a vague hum, despite no current of wind or physical activity. Pillars of immemorial years slept under fantastic patterns of vines, among which slept little gray apes whose dreams were restless. The columns arched backward upon their bases as centuried pillars extended along the flattened earth, and among the canopy of endless trees that ascended above the mountains was, weathered and half-obliterated, the gigantic altar which stood as a testament to ages long forgotten. The keeper knew nothing of what the altar stood for, as he was young and restless, accustomed only to the monotonous task of servicing the graves. Upon the end of each strenuous evening of thankless digging, the keeper would look longingly upward to that aged monument, and wish that he could visit its peak to see the lost and beautiful vistas of the world which might lay beyond. Atop that very architecture sat the elder, looking wistfully down upon the forests of Dun and its curious leaping apes and archaic ruins, hoping that one day his weary and dying body could carry him down to that land of which he always dreamed. For untold eons he played his viol. His mournful songs reminded him of days he could not remember, but neither fully forget. And for penance, the keeper dug in equal measures of time, until at last both men could no longer contain their spirits. And so each set out, leaving behind their instruments as they undertook their journeys. The elder picked up the shovel and began to dig. The keeper was weeping as he sat down to learn the viol.